Sitting of the House will now resume. I ask members to respect social distancing. Private notice question on the national lockdown, homelessness, for which 15 minutes are available. Baroness Grender.
My lords, I beg leave to ask a question of which I have given private notice.
On the 8th of January, the government set out further support for people who sleep rough as part of our ongoing world-leading work to protect the rough sleepers. In the light of the new strain, we are asking all local authorities to redouble their efforts to accommodate rough sleepers backed by £10 million. We are also asking areas to use this opportunity to make sure that all rough sleepers are registered with their GP and are factored into local area vaccination plans in line with the JVCI prioritisation for vaccinations.
I call Baroness Grender.
Everyone In was a success with great leadership from Baroness Casey, refusal to resort to the dangers of night shelters, and all sectors working together. So shouldn't that success be repeated? What guarantee can the Minister give that this time, with increased transmissibility and local authorities going broke, that no one will be refused a safe room and a roof? Does he agree that it is no longer everyone in if rough sleepers are being refused emergency help in this lockdown?
My Lords, everyone in was a tremendous programme, and that is why it continues to be in place. And I'd point out to the fact that 33,000 people have been helped and supported to the end of November, and we continue with this programme in place and build on the success that has saved many lives in the course of this pandemic.
I call Lord Boateng.
My Lords, many destitute asylum seekers, particularly those whose appeals have been refused and who have no recourse to public funds, find themselves homeless, turned away by local authorities. The Jesuit Refugee Service, West London Mission and others are doing a great job, but the public health danger is real. Will the government commit to ensuring funding for accommodation for everyone who needs it throughout the pandemic, irrespective of their immigration status? And if not, why not, if we're all in this together?
My Lords, I'd point to the statement I made around local government finance, where we saw core spending power increasing by 4.5%, and the derogation to London around no recourse to public funds has been widened to the rest of the country, so local authorities can show the local leadership required to keep communities, including rough sleepers, with no recourse to public funds.
I call Lord Bird.
I would like to commend the government on its last efforts, which I was involved in. It was a wonderful opportunity to be told about the policy and the work that was going on. Unfortunately, in spite of what the minister has said, there is no sense of policy. There is no sense of a sense of all things being joined up and coordinated. I myself have received no information in the same way that I was kept on the last occasion. There is this sense of the fact that we did it last time, but we're not doing it again this time. And I would say that the government really does need to be selling this and pushing it forward so that we can understand that it is working and when it is not working.
So there's no greater salesman than the noble Lord Bird. But I'd point out that we are backing up a commitment to end rough sleeping and to tackle homelessness with more cash. So this year, the total amount set in this current financial year, the amount is 700,000, a little over 700,000. Next year, we've committed 750,000 towards wider homelessness duties and also to end rough sleeping. That's a commitment that is an increasing amount of money to this endeavour.
I now call Lord Marks of Henley-on-Thames.
My Lords, last week's SI number 15 will permit evictions for 6 months' rent arrears. That is a harsh change from the present rules, which require 9 months arrears, and importantly, disregard arrears accrued since the start of the first lockdown, which the new rules won't. Robert Jenrick promised last March that no one should lose their home as a result of the coronavirus epidemic. Will not this change clearly break that pledge and increase homelessness at this very dangerous time?
My Lords, I think we can all accept that a full 6 months of rent arrears still amounts to egregious rent arrears. And so we don't agree with the noble lord on that point. It is important to get a fair balance between the interests of those that are tenants, but also landlord interests as well. That fair balance, this change with regard to rent arrears.
I call next Lord Lancaster of Kimbolton.
My Lords, one particularly impressive aspect of the Everyone In programme was the opportunity it gave local authorities to deliver a wraparound programme for homeless people. So can I ask my noble friend what assessment he's made of the number of people who have been transitioned into a home of their own, and also what really opportunity this might give for the future?
Well, my Lords, I thank my noble friend for highlighting the importance of the wraparound care that's required to get people into settled accommodation. And I'd point, first of all, to the budget of £433 million over 3 years to now enable people to move from temporary accommodation into more settled accommodation. But what we're talking about is that we've supported around 33,000 people with nearly 10,000 in emergency accommodation. Those are substantial numbers. There's no doubt this programme has saved lives.
I now call the Lord Bishop of Manchester.
I thank the noble Lord, the Minister, for his replies.
Saved lives.
I now call the Lord Bishop of Manchester.
I thank the noble Lord, the Minister, for his replies to date and indeed for his personal in coronavirus. Would he encourage Her Majesty's Government, though, to prioritise the vaccination of all homeless people as a cohort, including those who don't fall neatly into one of the existing priority groups?
I think the most important thing is to define terms. Certainly, rough sleepers are very much considered to be a priority category, and that is. But you make a case for whether we should consider the broader category of those with a statutory duty to be housed, who may be in accommodation but not in settled accommodation. And I'll take forward and see how we can make sure that the vaccination goes to the most needy groups, which I'm sure is the point behind the question.
I call Lord Kennedy of Southwark.
My Lords, I refer the House to my relevant interests as set out in the register. The responses are from the noble Lord. The solutions are not, by any means, they're not world class, they're not world beating, and they are not world leading. They are extremely disappointing. We had people sleeping rough in our streets last week, last night, and we'll have again tonight. If you want to go to Waterloo Station, there's a whole group of tents at Waterloo Station where people are sleeping there in the bridge between the station and Waterloo Road. And the Prime Minister and the members of government tell us this pandemic is serious, and it is deadly serious, and lives will be lost. There's no justification for not today, getting every single homeless person off the street. They'll have particular vulnerabilities. We must do this, and we're not doing what we did last time.
Well, my Lords, the noble Lords reminded me to declare my residential and commercial property interests as set out in the register. So I thank him for that. I also understand where you're coming from. We have, as a government, a moral mission to end rough sleeping. That's not an easy task, as the noble Lord Kennedy knows, but we will do our utmost. And the first thing is we prioritise the cash, more escalating amounts of money to do precisely that, but we will need the support of local government. And you point to Waterloo, and we know that's in the noble Lord's patch, if you like, and we need the support then of the London Borough of Southwark to show the leadership required to deal with this issue.
I call next Lord Crisp.
With this scheme and this campaign, but like others, I'm disappointed that it's not being followed through quite as wholeheartedly as it might be. Let me ask two questions relating directly to health. The first one is, what evidence is there of homeless people and rough sleepers unwittingly transmitting, spreading the virus? And has the government made an assessment of how many homeless people have indeed had the virus or been admitted to hospital?
Now, my Lords, those are very detailed questions, and I deserve to give you a proper written answer to give you the information such as I can find it. But I would say that I've met with the vaccine czar, Nadeem Zahawi, last week, and very much the cohort of rough sleepers are a priority cohort to ensure that they get timely vaccination.
I call Baroness Bakewell of Hardington Mandeville.
My Lords, during the last lockdown, local authorities did an amazing job with many rough sleepers saying they felt valued for the first time. We are now in the depths of winter, and many rough sleepers are extremely vulnerable to COVID-19. I welcome the Everybody In funding, but can the Minister say whether this will indeed cover those who are suffering with addictions, sometimes more than one addiction, and are very vulnerable, especially in rural areas?
Well, the vulnerability is incredibly important to understand, and that's why the government put £10 million on the table for local authorities that know their communities best to come up with the plans to target those rough sleepers, to give them the support, the wraparound care that's needed. And that's how we'll proceed, in partnership with the local leaders at a local level.
I call next Lord Young of Cookham.
My Lords, like others, I welcome the government's instruction on Friday to local authorities to redouble their efforts to accommodate those sleeping rough. This will help achieve the target by 2024. But can I ask my noble friend about numbers? In 2019, the government estimated the number of rough sleepers at 4,000. As a result of Everyone In, we now know that of the 15,000 people supported, 7,000 people have been sleeping rough. Does this not underline the need for a better measurement of rough sleepers if we're going to hit our target?
No, I thank my noble friend because I agree that we have through this pandemic got much more of a grip of the quantum involved if we want to end rough sleeping. We also know that there may not be rough sleeping in the true sense of the word, but they are sofa surfers. They're on the edge of being rough sleepers, and so understanding more about the cohort and what it will take to resource this is the only way that we can deliver on the government's moral mission to end rough sleeping for good.
I call Baroness Armstrong of Hilltop.
My Lords, I'm sure the Minister will agree that Housing Justice have done a fantastic job in providing winter night shelters, with the rolling church model being central, particularly for those who have no access to public funding. However, whilst the people involved should be commended and thanked, this model is not adequate during a pandemic. There is likely to be only one or two toilets and inadequate washing facilities, and people have to move on each day. Can the government guarantee that there will be sufficient safe accommodation to close the night shelters and ensure that every rough sleeper is housed safely? We did manage to do it first time round. Will the government show the leadership that's necessary to ensure it this time round?
Well, my Lords, I first thank the frontline workers in those night shelters, and it's very important we recognise that in the current pandemic they're putting themselves at risk and that they need to be prioritised in the same way that we prioritise those that work in the National Health Service and other care workers. I would say that you've got a real commitment to get people off the streets into a setting which is COVID secure and safe, and then to find the right accommodation. That's backed up by more cash than ever to ensure that we do, in time, end rough sleeping.
I call next Lord Harris of Pentregarth.
The City of Manchester has been remarkably successful in rehousing rough sleepers. 3 years ago, there were 356 long-term rough sleepers, and now 79% of those are in housing, and a percentage of them are receiving appropriate help for mental health, drug or alcohol-related problems. What lessons can the government learn from the policy of this City of Manchester to pass on to other local authorities?
I'm delighted that you raise the excellence of the City of Manchester. That is an example of fantastic local leadership. Fantastic. Sir Richard Leese, a long-time leader of the City of Manchester, a fantastic local leader. Howard Bernstein, a fantastic chief executive. What I'd say about Manchester, the City of Manchester, is what the City of Manchester does today is what other local authorities should do tomorrow. That is the message of the City of Manchester.
I call the final speaker, Lord Bourne of Aberystwyth.
My Lords, I congratulate the government on the success of Everyone In, the first rollout of that scheme. It was highly successful, and I hope that we're able to replicate that in the second rollout of the scheme. My Lords, I'd like to ask the noble Lord, the Minister, about vaccination, which he has referenced, and ask what percentage of those that were accommodated through Everyone In the first phase have registered with GPs so that we can ensure the vaccine rollout for this essential group of people. Unless we're ensuring that these people are registered, they will, I regret, slip through the system. So I'm sure the government's onto it, but I'd welcome some stats to back that up.
I thank my noble friend for testing my statistical knowledge, but I think I'd rather than plucking a number out of the air in my current disposition where I can't see particularly well, I prefer to write to my noble friend on that matter. But he's right, we do understand this, we have gripped the problem, and we'll give you the numbers to back that up.
My Lords, all supplementary questions have been asked.